Hi, it's Russ from Pro's Expert, and I've got myself a copy of the Positive Grid BAIS Desktop guitar modeling plugin. Now, they're already well known and already well loved by the iPad community when they made the iOS version of this, and this is the desktop version. So they already have a track record in this. I saw a review of this today who actually called it a guitar effects processor. It's not a guitar effects processor. It's a guitar modeling system. And basically, it gives you 36 amps that you can then tweak to your heart's content. So it gives you lots of really cool stuff that you can start off with, preamps, the tone stack, and we'll go through all that in a while. And there are two versions. There are the basic version, $99, and then the pro version for $199, and I'll tell you the difference. So first things I'm going to do is show you all the stuff that comes with both versions, and then I'll talk about the additional stuff you get as well. So what's very cool is to say you can go in and you can straight away start going through the amps, and you have a preamp section, and then the tone stack section, the power amp section, the transformers, and the cabs, and the microphone, and the placement of the microphone. And then you have two EQs. You can bring an EQ before and an EQ after into the line as well. And then it's just a case of you going through and trying out the different models and geeking to your heart's content. So, as I say, there's a custom panel to start with. And what you can do with the custom panel, you can come in here and you can, as it says, customize it. So we change the panel and we want to change the background there. We'll go for silver or acoustic or American black. And then we can go in a bit further and change the grill cloth and go in again and change the, I've done that one already, the knobs. So as you can see, straight away you can do a bit of fun with the GUI. That's the kind of visual side of it. But what really matters is the sound side of it. So as I say, here's a guitar that James Ivy played for me. So it's a DI. Now let's hear that now with this sound on it. And we can then go through and start trying things. So we could try different preamps. We could try clean. So. And the stack as well, go for clean. And on the preamp as well. Can hear now, we need to put that up a bit louder, and we could change the mic, so we turn that up a bit, so go to the preamp. But we can then get really geeky. We can go into the preamp, for example, here, and we could start changing the valves. You can hear that those bigger valves are giving you some more thrap. Lose the distortion or drive them harder. Make it warmer. Change the tube staging. Can even change the bias. You could hear there. As it changes, it's quite sweet. Dry them hotter. Then go to the tone stack. Then to the power amp. So you can see by going through, you can really change stuff, and you've got things like solid state here in the topology. Then into the transformer. Push the heart. Attack. And you can hear, you can really do a lot of tweaking. Then we can go to the cab. Tons of different cabs. You can hear they make a difference. Then we can change the mic or move it around. There's a 414 and a 57. Now what you can do as well, and a really nice feature in the EQ, is I'm going to pull the EQ post, so it's there now and it's in. It's got a really nice preset, and that preset is called Paper Speaker. And one thing I find that most amp models I don't like about them is they're kind of fizzy at the top end. And the great thing about Paper Speaker is it just rolls off all that top end. And for me, that's far more authentic. So all the stuff I've shown you so far, come down the bottom here as well, you've got the hum noise reduction. So if you've got hum coming off a guitar, turn that on and then just turn the depth up to adjust. Then you have a noise gate. So if you're using, this comes post, and if you're using some pretty noisy stuff, can hear that? Let's put this in now. Just go threshold. And a decay so it doesn't snap too hard. Now the nice thing as well is this room control. This isn't a reverb as such. It's more putting the amp as if it's in a room with a mic on it. So you can get some nice, really small rooms. Damp it. Get really big if you want. But even subtly, if I turn that off now, that's very sort of dry. I like that. So let me tell you what you get with the Pro version. So everything I've shown you so far is the $99 version. And of course, the best thing about it as well is the Tone Cloud, where you can go in and you can find an amp. And you can demo it online. So let's choose this one. Fireballs, that seems to be popular at the moment. I think I like that one, so I can download that. And that's then in my amp list. I'll go to latest as well. Try this sort of orange crunch machine. Now the good thing as well, you can search, so we could go jazz. And I can like it and I can comment on it as well. So there's all that cool stuff. So let's stop that now. And if I come back now out the tone and come back to my own list here, come all the way to the bottom, I've got this custom lot, and these are all the ones I've downloaded already. So there's the ones I've gone through, and find there's the fireballs I just downloaded. Some more I've been downloading. Brian May. Someone's done a version of Brian May's AC30. Now what you can hear straight away, and it's the immediacy of the sound is really nice. It really captures this plugin, that immediacy that you get off the guitar amp. You can hear that there, and that's because you've got all that super tweakability. So all the things I've shown you so far are what comes with the $99 version. So let me show you the stuff that then comes with the paid for version. The first thing is that it ships with a load of presets and that have been made clean. So it's got a different sound. Mm. Now, right up then to crunch. Some high gain. So as you can see, there's a huge amount of variety in there. Now, of course, you'll see on this list as well, there's acoustic stuff and there's bass stuff as well for the bass players out there. So it's usable on acoustic and electric and on bass. Now, the final thing that it ships with as well that's really nice is the ability to amp match. And what that means is if you hear a guitar sound on a track or you've got a guitar in a studio, like a vintage Fender Twin or an AC30 from 1965, what you can do is you can amp match by getting the audio to go in, you capture the source, then you capture the target, and then it matches it, and you can then save that as a preset. So you can basically sample amps off tracks or amps, live amps as well. Now, there's a great video that's been produced that is on their YouTube channel. It's well worth watching. It's a much better video than I could ever make with a guy using a high watt amp. So that comes with amp matching, and as you'll see, it's pretty convincing. And there's a couple of, as I say, videos that you can go and watch doing that. So there we are. It comes with 36 amp models to start with, and it comes with Tone Cloud and all the other features that I've shown you in the basic. Plus, if you want to go to the pro version, then you have the ability to have all the presets, the custom presets, and also the amp matching technology. Of all the guitar sims I've heard, this is pretty damn good. I've got an 11 rack, and as you know from other reviews I've done, I've listened to most guitar modeling technology. And as a plugin, setting aside stuff like Kemper that's out there and things like that, and other stuff, this for $99, which is effectively £60 in the UK, or £130 for the pro version, I think it's a killer plugin. And for those who just want to get a great sound, then you can do that. And for those who want to tweak until their heart's content and change the tubes and the transformers and the biasing and that, then you get that too. It's the best of both worlds. For that reason, it gets my Editor's Choice Award. It's a big thumbs up from me. It sounds great. It's easy to use, even if you're going to geek out. And say the added extra of the Tone Cloud is a real bonus for those who are looking for sounds immediately. And that bit of it, of course, is that you're not going into a Tone Cloud and then saying it's £4 to buy this. You just download them from people who are making them. I think anything that's built around a music community is always going to be good. And so that's a big win for me, a big thumbs up. So well done, the guys at Positive Grid. This is a great product, and I suggest you download the demo and try it for yourself and make your own mind up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.